Hey gang, Sam Ward here with a simple thought for today. All of life is worship, and we worship by loving one another. This past weekend, we had a little bit of a crisis 10 minutes before service. The soundboard in our second worship space decided to stop working, or at least half work and half not work. 10 minutes before service, and what do? Freak out! Gung, 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 gung. A freak out! That's what a lot of us did. That's what I was tempted to do. Because we had a service to get on in about 10 minutes. Actually, though, that wasn't the main problem. We had two problems. The first problem, obviously, get the soundboard running so we can get the service up in 10 minutes. The other problem was, could we do that in a way that was loving and caring? I've been in a lot of churches where things get crazy right before a service, things get crazy during a Christmas play rehearsal or whatever else is going on. And then the event happens and everyone goes, oh, but it was wonderful. It went really well. As if that takes care of all of the mess and the chaos that happened in rehearsal beforehand. I'd suggest not so. I'd suggest that the way that we love each other, the way that we care for each other in rehearsal, is just as important as what happens within a service or a production. Did you know that there are 59 one another's in the New Testament? These are 59 statements about the way that we're supposed to love, treat, and care for each other. Let's talk about love. John, over three times. Romans 13, love one another. 1 Peter, love one another deeply. 1 and 2 John, six times, love one another. Jesus even said, love one another as I have loved you. And so that includes a rehearsal 10 minutes before a service when the soundboard stops working. We are called to love one another because the way that we lead in a service is just as important as the way that we love one another in a rehearsal. All of life is worship, and worship is the way that we love one another.